The design is good. The design is good because the designer of marriage is good. How many people believe that? Really, come on, at the end of the day, we have to start this marriage journey with a positive mindset that, hey, the design is good. The design can be trusted because the designer is good and can be trusted. It's amazing how if you launch into any journey and you have a negativity pervading, you'll find that you are really setting yourself up for defeat every single time. I remember last year I was preaching in Cleveland before they broke their massive, you know, that long losing streak. And I remember I was in Cleveland, I was preaching at a church, and they had all gathered around to watch this game because they felt they had a chance of breaking that losing streak. But the negativity that filled their room, it didn't surprise me that they worked out how to snatch defeat from the jaws of victory right at the last moment, because negativity will set you up for defeat most of the time. And so many people launch into marriage. They launch into this season of their life with so much negativity that swirls. Statistics that are here, statistics that are there, horror stories that are here, horror stories that are there. But we have to draw a line in the sand and declare once and for all that the designer of marriage is good and he can be trusted. And if we would make a decision to do marriage his way, we are set up for success. In the beginning, he worked it out. I'm going to find one man and one woman, and I'm going to cleave them together for this reason. This man is going to leave his mother and father, and they are going to become one flesh as they are united. There is nothing wrong with the design, because the designer is good. And if we would trust the designer, we will see success, and we will see joy in our journey in marriage. Can someone say a good amen to that?